If you're looking for a great YouTube network to join, apply for Fullscreen with the link in the description. To trade your games in for a better value, use LeapTrade.com and use Broken Games HD as a referral. Download the Broken Games HD Android app to keep up to date with all videos and social media. Alright, what's going on, y'all? So here is another Halo 5 Guardians beta match on the other map that's available, because there's only two maps available, Truth, and I forgot what the other one is. It's the one that I did my first impressions on. And Slayer, obviously, is the game mode, because that's currently the only game mode available. Possibly later on in the beta. I believe they will be releasing some other game modes during this beta, which it lasts about 2 weeks. Not sure about any more maps, though. Hopefully there will be, though. Of course, I render this in 1080p, 60 frames per second, so make sure you watch it in 60 frames, because I don't render in that for my health. So watch it. Open up the Google Chrome browser. Watch it in 60 frames. It looks real good. And yes, I'm very well aware that the game, actually, the beta isn't rendered at 1080p. Possibly the full game might be. Possibly. But currently the beta is 720p at 60 frames. Doesn't mean, of course, I can't render it. So let's talk a little bit more about the game. So I just did a live stream, and I think I was live streaming for about 3 hours. And let me tell you something. I've been having the time of my life with this game. I had a rough start in this game, in this match right here, but I turned it on. I've been having a blast with this game. Just mad fun with this. People who watch my live stream know. They know. I was screaming, but not like rage screaming. I was just screaming because I was having so much fun. I was just having a blast with this. I haven't wanted to put this game down yet. Not yet. Even though there's only two maps and one mode, I haven't wanted to put the game down yet. Started playing the game yesterday when I did my first impressions. Only reason I put it down is because I had to go to work. I needed some sleep first, and then I had to go to work because I work overnight. As soon as I got back home this morning, turned the X1 right on, got right back into it. Haven't put it down since, only to stop the live stream. And then even after the live stream, I kept on playing and recorded this. So I've been having a blast with this game. I've been having a lot of fun. It's made me very much excited for 2015 and all the great multiplayer experiences that will be coming in that year. Like I said, if I had played this beta before making my highly anticipated games list, this would have been on it. If I would have played all the matches I've played so far and then made that list, it would have been in a pretty good position. It would have probably been in top five. I can say that. Strictly for the multiplayer, yes. One thing that is kind of strange that I noticed is that I got used to this game extremely quickly. You know when you first play a game and you kind of got the new game cobwebs, the new game rust, you're still adjusting? That only lasted for about a few matches. After that, I felt like I had been playing this game for weeks when I literally had only played about, you know, five matches. Everything just felt so natural, so fluid. I felt like I've been playing like Halo nonstop, and it was just a seamless transition. It was just natural. It just flowed, right? To the point where I tapped into my, you know, your gamer autopilot, where when you're playing a game, you're in the zone. You don't think, you just act, you just react. That's how it became when I started playing this after a few matches. Everything just clicked, just flowed, you know, wasn't thinking. I just reacted, and you know, I was just beasting. And this game, it's been fun just by me, you know, not talking to anybody, not partying up with anybody, just, you know, playing with a whole bunch of randoms. And it's been fun with just two maps and one game mode, so I could just imagine how much of a blast I'm gonna have, you know, if they release some more content for the beta or when the actual game dropped. And surprisingly, I had some really good teammates on this match, because usually they suck. And in this video, I wanted to make sure I kind of you know, utilized all the different weapons. As you can see, I used SMG, you know, the DMR, Of course, the battle rifle, and eventually at the end of the game, I do pick up the energy sword, which I hate that people when people use it against me. The energy sword isn't so bad anymore because obviously there's the thrust you can use to avoid it. There is the lunge with the energy sword, but it's not as pronounced as it used to be, and it's not all the time. You know, it's a short lunge. It's not as bad as it's been in previous games, but overall, I think you hit the skill threshold, like the skill ceiling or roof in this game. I think you hit it pretty fast, which could be a problem. Because one thing with games now is you feel like you reach your full potential as far as how good you're gonna get in the game pretty fast. I remember games back in the day, you know, you could look back months and, you know, feel like, wow, from months ago, I've really improved in this game, right? You feel like you're just a much better player than you were whatever amount of months ago, whatever amount of weeks ago. Like, you learned just the unique details about the game, the small, minute details that just make you a better player. But with games now, I feel like you obtain all the information, all the little neat tricks and nuances of games so fast that you reach your cap of everything you know about the game, and you reach your cap in terms of skill, you know, fast, pretty fast. And that kind of takes away from the, I guess, the evolving and the growing and just improving, you know, which kind of, takes away from the excitement and thrill to play, because you already feel like you reach your maximum potential. At this point, you're just playing just to play. And I think with games now, that's what happens way too fast, because the, you know, the learning curve is so low, right? It's such a small learning curve, and you don't really have much skill to build. You know, you hit your roof really fast, and it reminded me of Titanfall in that way, because just after playing a few matches in Titanfall, and I know a lot of people also agreed with me about this, is after just playing a few matches of Titanfall, you feel like you know the game, just like the back of your hand. You know the game. And I guess that, you know, overall just comes with the fact that, yeah, they did make this game easier and more accessible. It is what it is. That's the day and age we're in. I would have probably liked the game if they would have kept it more traditional Halo. I think I would have liked it anyway. Either way, it's you know, it's like whatever to me. Either way, I probably would have been fine with it. So it's not a huge problem, just something I've noticed. But I mean, I've been having a really good time with this game, and it surprised me, because I have been feeling burnt out on first person shooters. Look at my dumb self right now. I accidentally pick up the energy sword, then accidentally switch back and drop it. Now I'm looking at my dumb ass, like, where did I drop the energy sword? I don't know. Oh, we're all there at this, dummy. What was I saying? I don't even remember. Honestly, don't. Yeah, I was saying I have been feeling burnt out on first-person shooters, but for some reason, I'm not experiencing the same effects when I play this game. You know, it doesn't feel like I'm playing the generic. Look at me miss. One thing I kept on doing is I always try to dash forward and hit them with the energy sword, use the thrusters. But, you know, the energy sword already has, you know, its little own thrusting, so I thrust right past that guy, but end up getting them anyway. So I gotta stop doing that. So yeah, I haven't been getting that first-person shooter fatigue and saturation like I have with other games. It just feels, you know, different. I'm not gonna say it feels original or new. It just feels different, and that it's fun. So yeah, that's it, y'all. I'm out of here. Peace.